Working parents can spend months searching for the perfect daycare, but before you check them in, check them out. How do their inspections stack up? Are they licensed? And has a program ever been investigated by the state? You might think these are easy questions to find answers to, but as we uncovered, it's anything but. Tonight, WHNT News 19's chief investigative reporter, Carrie Marchese, is taking action for parents.
For the last 2 months, WHNT News 19 has worked with the state of Alabama to obtain dozens of complaint records from local daycare centers. And what I have in my hands is definitely worth a second glance and difficult information to obtain. And the point of this story is, we think it shouldn't be.
It's one of the hardest decisions a parent must make. Who do I trust to care for my child? Many parents don't know where to start and what questions to ask.
Have there been issues in the past?
And here lies the problem. You're staring at daycare complaints from centers in Madison, Morgan, and Limestone counties within the last 18 months. And there are dozens more where those came from. They've been investigated and validated by the Alabama Department of Human Resources, and their public information. In fact, the state told us you should be able to ask the facility managers if you're curious. So we did, but not as a media organization, as a concerned parent armed with a hidden camera.
I was wondering if I could get some information about having my child enrolled here.
These complaints about a facility in Morgan County detail an incident in May of 2011, where the state investigated three allegations and determined them to be true. A child injured, medical attention was needed, and physical restraint was used.
So you guys haven't had any complaints or anything with DHR where they've had to investigate?
Our undercover producer got nothing. Perhaps the situation was long forgotten. Next, a Huntsville center with multiple complaints, much more recent.
This is what our curriculum looks like.
The biggest problem here is what's called staff-to-child ratio. In eight instances over a year, the state substantiated the number of staff to children was a problem, and in one case found a class of 12 children ages 2 to 3 years old with just one teacher. The state requires two teachers for that many children. In all, 9 confirmed complaints over the course of a year at this daycare alone. None of that information was relayed to us. And before you discount the staff-to-child ratio trend, here's what Barry Spears, the public information manager from DHR, told us. While safety is a significant factor in determining staff-to-child ratios, it also affects the quality of care a provider can give to each child. He goes on to say, higher staff-to-child ratios are required for younger children, partly because they are at greater risk of serious injury or death from abuse. Another Madison daycare also had staff-to-child ratio issues, as well as incidents of rough or harsh handling and verbal abuse confirmed by DHR in 2012.
Have you had any complaints as far as, like, with DHR where they've had to come out?
No, we actually had something where there was an incident with the teacher. It was 2 years ago, mm-hmm. where there was an incident with their teacher, and we actually had to let the teacher go.
The Department of Human Resources told me there's really no good reason a center should conceal this information, and ethically, they should just be forthcoming about it. Now, right now, there is no law for daycare centers to post substantiated complaints at their daycare or online.
But all centers must post this, a public notice with a toll-free number. Notice, part of this note is directed towards parents who want to report a complaint. The other part is to obtain information about substantiated complaints from DHR. At two of the schools we shopped, this form was not in plain sight, and the state was clear it should be out in the open for all to see. At the third daycare, it was posted, but as you can clearly see, it was partially covered up. And when we asked the questions over and over,
No
one pointed us to this notice.
Quality is our main thing with our school.
Quality is good, but so is transparency, especially when it all comes down to this.
Now, we called the daycare centers we visited and asked them to speak with us on camera. They declined, although one center said to me on the phone they would welcome the idea of a statewide database where all of this information was readily available for parents.
Very interesting story. Carrie, what are we going to do with the information that you obtained?
Well, as you saw, we didn't reveal the daycares in
right.
our hidden camera investigation. However, all this information, these substantiated complaints that we received from DHR, mm-hmm. from Madison, Morgan, and Limestone counties, they are all going on WHNT.com. For the last 18 months, that's the time frame it covers. And also, we're working with the state right now, too, to get more records for all of our viewing areas, all the other counties here in Alabama. And as soon as we get those for that 18-month time period, we're going to also put those on WHNT.com.
All right. Let us know. Thank you, Carrie.
You got it.